what can you say about one of the poorest cities in the state of Michigan? The needs are so great here. I mean, some of our families struggle with basic needs like housing, medical care, food, you know, just the basic necessities. And the median income in Benton Harbor is less than $10,000. So just being able to show them how to take their little pennies and make much has been the challenge.
You're the God of this city. You're the King of these people. You're the Lord of this nation. You are. You're the light in this darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless.
You are. We are a premier destination for children. And so we started our program off basically mentoring an after-school program for children who were two grade levels behind in their schoolwork. And since that time, it has grown to meet the needs of the children, mind, body, and spirit. Can't help the children without helping the family unit as a whole. So, you know, I have taken on the role as life coach, and so a lot of times I help parents budget the little money that they do get. I have to teach them how to create basic meals and then create a lot of it so that they can freeze it and learn how to repurpose it, getting a lot of the sugars and the dyes out of their diet. People come to me and they say they have a problem, you know, even that language. Or the children come to me in our after school program or in our Christian school and say what they can't do. I immediately remove that apostrophe T. So that's just my nature as a whole. So even though it looks dismal at times in our small town, I always find the silver lining in the situation, and I always seek to find viable solutions to whatever the problem is. So if housing is a problem, if I have to turn them on to temporary housing, if I have to, many of them are on a waiting list to receive some type of voucher, you know, so that they can have a place to call home. I consider Lighthouse as a resource center. So whenever I hear of a job opening, I'll brush them up on interview skills, our clothing closet, I'll go in and get them something free of charge. I'll do a mock interview with them. I'll show them how to fill out an application and present themselves in the best light. So if you tell me a job is an issue, I got a remedy for that. If you tell me housing is an issue, I have a remedy for that. If you tell me medical is an issue, I'll find someone who can help you if you can't help yourself or your children. Well, this building, which is behind me, was erected in 1919. And so we took it on about 4 years ago. And I have to tell you, it has been a blessing, but it has been a curse. I mean, just think of a person who was born in 1919. Your organs are not the same. You know, the way you function is not the same. So back in 1919, it was one of the premier churches on this corner, meeting the needs of its community. But over the course of the years, and we will be celebrating 100 years, you know, in 4 years, one of my greatest challenges right now is a fundraising effort to bring our building up to code. Like, for instance, we could have had air in our building for summer camp, and you know these cinder blocks are not forgiving. When it's hot outside, it's extremely hot on the inside. When it's cold outside, it's the same. But because we lack a $30,000, we could finish putting our air in and tying our heat in to be able to continue to serve the children and the families in this community. So that's my greatest need right now, as well as getting volunteers, trying to get others to come and to care and to serve and to be the hands and feet of Jesus. That is a challenge. The need is great.